part two. In part one, we covered the trap of believing that others are responsible for our feelings. As an adult, it is our responsibility to control our own happiness, to understand that we are creating the feelings that we have. And if our life or our relationship or our friendship isn't what it needs to be, the work is ours to do. If the person magically operated exactly as you want in your expectations, you would not be content. You would just dream up other stuff for them to do. If we set it up, if we come from the premise of others are responsible for our happiness, we're setting ourselves up to be disappointed, to be hurt. We're setting ourselves up to have people move away from us. It affects our life. It's life limiting. And the quality of our life goes down when we set up that premise. This is part two. In part one, again, we talked about others being responsible for our feelings. Well, the other thing that we teach our kids, which is a massive, massive trap, is that if others are responsible for our feelings, then we are responsible for other people's feelings. What I mean by this is, if you just go be a lawyer, you're going to make your dad so proud. But I don't want to be a lawyer. Yeah, but if you're a lawyer, you're going to make your dad so proud. If you just do this for me, I'm going to be so happy. But that goes against my conscience. I don't feel like that's what I want to be doing. I know, but it's going to make me so happy if you do that. And we have millions of people that we can call people pleasers, approval seekers. We massively compromise our own beliefs, our own conscience, when we do this. Now, for a lot of us, it is not our fault until today. What do you mean by it's not our fault until today? For a lot of us, this belief system of you have to do things or take actions or be something to make others happy, a lot of us, this was ingrained in us as a child by mom or dad or grandma or grandpa or whoever it was. This was ingrained in us. And at that point, as a kid, we don't get to defend ourselves against really bad belief systems that others are pretty much imposing on us, right? We don't have a filter as a seven-year-old when we're collecting all the data on how to be. So we're just taking that in from an authority figure and we're saying, okay, well, that's a correct thought on that. I can't challenge it. I don't have the awareness to challenge that. So I just take it in as correct information. And so mom badgers us for our whole lives, do what mom wants and I'm going to be happy. Oh my gosh, I'm not happy right now because of this thing you did or didn't do, right? And kind of that sets us up for a really bad pattern. So now, today, we have the light bulb. Aha! I'm not responsible for other people's happiness. They're responsible for their happiness. They're the ones creating the feelings inside that they have. And if the feelings aren't what they need them to be, it's their responsibility to go do what they need to do to have produce the feelings that they want to have. That's not on me anymore, okay? So boom, we have the light bulb moment now. Time out. The problem is having that awareness intellectually is not enough. You can pay a lot of people money to give you some awareness. The problem is awareness doesn't equate to recovery. What do we mean by recovery? We mean recovering what was taken from us by grief and loss, recovering the quality of life that we had before, or finding a way to get the quality of life that we've never had. Again, that's our responsibility. So going back to the awareness piece, I intellectually understand what you're saying, Cole. Okay, great. Emotionally, we still have a massive iceberg underneath the water, and we have to address that. It's very hard to change our belief system if we don't get emotionally complete with the relationship that gave us the belief system to start with. It's hard. You can't really just fast forward into, okay, I have this new awareness. I'm going to now move forward and understand that others... happiness is not given or granted by me. I'm going to make my own choices and insist that they satisfy me so I can live the life that I want to live. Just having that statement and that awareness intellectually is not enough. We have to go do the work that we need to do to grieve and complete what is emotionally unfinished in that past relationship so that we can give that belief system or that piece of that belief system back to that person. All of a sudden, now back in real time after we go and do that work, right, that foundational piece, after we do that, now in real time, we can be a lot more accountable to ourselves the next time we're about to go off and do something that doesn't feel right for us to do because we think someone else's happiness is contingent upon us doing that. We can stop in real time and understand, oh, I'm doing that again. I'm giving that back to mom because that's not mine. That was mom's stuff and it doesn't feel right for me. It's my responsibility as an adult to have control of my actions because I'm an adult. I'm 43 years old. It's on me to create my own happiness and it's on them to create their own happiness. I'm not a player in someone else's play. I'm not an actor in someone else's film. That's on them to do that work, okay? But again, just understanding this is only one piece of it. We gotta go and remove the energy around how this happened. Otherwise, when you have the next stimulus or the next person asking you to do something, that will carry a lot more energy and it's already familiar to you how to take that action and do that. And then you look back and you go, oh, I did it again. We don't want that for you guys. We want you to be able to live life and find the quality of life that you want and be the person that you want, not who grandma and grandpa wanted us to be or mom or dad. We want to find who you want to be today. And again, a lot of the time, these people in our lives are great people. They gave us a lot of great belief systems. But no one's perfect, and we pick up a lot of bad stuff from these people, well-intentioned or not. Some of us have horrible examples growing up, and we got more work to do, just part of the deal. But as long as we have actions and tools, then we're okay, because we know what to do. It all comes from that responsibility in yourself to do the work you need to do. It's our responsibility to create our own happiness. We are creating the feelings that we produce internally. And if they're not good, we got to identify it and know what to do about those feelings. Okay? So remember, part one was others are responsible for our feelings. If you fall into that camp, go check out that video. This video is about I am responsible for other people's happiness. That is also not true. So if that's you and you really seek approval and you do a bunch of stuff you don't want to be doing because you think people won't be happy if I don't do this, this, and this because that's what they requested, just know that you're setting yourself up for pain and for discomfort and for not being congruent with yourself. And we don't want that for you. So think about that. And if you want help, please come and work with us. We all have grief and loss and unresolved trauma and pain and hurt. Everyone qualifies from this work. Everyone benefits from coming here and taking the actions of the grief recovery method. You don't even need to know really what you're grieving. We'll help you find it, I promise. And this work will not be a waste of time or a waste of an investment, I promise. I've seen it work for too many people. I've seen it work for 19-year-olds. I've seen it work for 75-year-olds. I've seen it work for people grieving a death. I've seen it work for people grieving relationships with mom and dad who just didn't ever show up as mom and dad. I've seen people grieve losses of health, loss of trust, loss of control of my body, trauma, sexual abuse, moving. There's lots of different events in our lives that are grief, that are loss, that are trauma, emotional pain and hurt. This work applies to all of it. If you are not at the quality of your life, if you're not living life exactly how you want to, if you feel like you're falling short as a friend, as a leader of your family, as a husband, as a wife, as a teacher, as a friend, if you are falling short, grief recovery can help you. Unresolved emotional pain robs us of choice, it drains us of energy, and it affects every decision that we make. So do something about it. Come and work with us. I promise you, we provide rock-solid tools that have been perfected over 40 years. I love you guys. Thank you.